G'day and welcome to my brewery. Today we are talking about yeast pitching temperatures. Some brewers swear by pitching cold, while others like to pitch warm. But which one is actually better? It depends, and today we're going to break it down a little bit, warm versus cold pitching, and when to use each one for your best results. Here to answer another question from YouTube. Why pitching temp matters? First, let's talk about why pitching temp matters. When yeast is added to wort, it kicks off fermentation, producing alcohol, CO2, and all the flavors we love. But if the yeast is too hot or too cold at the start, it can change how the fermentation plays out. So let's break it down. Pitching cold and when to do it. Pitching yeast colder than your target fermentation temperature, usually 3 to 5 degrees Celsius or 5 to 10 degrees Fahrenheit below, is great for certain styles, and here's why brewers do it. Better fermentation control. A slow, controlled start prevents yeast from generating too much heat and going out of control. It can help with a cleaner flavour profile. This helps reduce fruity esters, harsh fusel alcohols, especially in lagers and clean ales. It minimises contamination risk. Bacteria thrive at higher temperatures, so cold pitching gives your yeast a better chance to dominate. Pitching warm, why and when? Now let's talk about warm pitching. Adding yeast at or slightly above the target fermentation temperature, why would you want to do this? Well, it actually can be beneficial in certain situations. Faster fermentation. Warm yeast is active yeast. Less lag time means a quicker start and a lower risk of wild yeast or bacteria taking over. More ester production and phenol production. If you want fruity esters or spicy phenols like in a Belgian ale or Hefeweizen, a warm start can enhance those flavours. It avoids cold shock. Some ale yeast can go dormant or slow down if pitched too cold, leading to sluggish or stuck fermentations. So if you're brewing something like a Saison, a Hef, or a Hazy IPA where you want big yeast character, pitching a little warmer makes sense. For example, many ale yeasts are pitched around 19 to 24 C, or that's 67 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit, to promote good activity. But there's a catch. The yeast pitch rate factor. The amount of yeast you pitch, called the pitch rate, also plays a big role in whether you should go warm or cold. Here's the deal. Underpitching, not enough yeast. If you don't have enough yeast, pitching warm helps them multiply faster and reduces lag time. But be careful. Without good temp control, warm fermentation can get out of hand quickly. Proper or over-pitching. Plenty of yeast. Cold pitching is best. If you have a full, healthy pitch of yeast and you don't need them to multiply as much, cold pitching helps keep the fermentation controlled and prevents excessive off flavors. This is why temperature control is so important. If you pitch warm, you need to make sure the temperature doesn't spike. If you pitch cold, you need to ensure the yeast doesn't stall out. Which one should you choose? So what's the best method? Well, it depends on what you're brewing and your yeast situation. Here's a quick recap. Pitch cold if you want a clean fermentation. Lagers, IPAs, clean ales. You have the proper pitch rate, plenty of yeast. Very rarely will that be one packet of yeast in a homebrew batch. Usually it will be two or more packets or a large active starter. You want to control yeast activity and prevent runaway fermentation. Pitch warm, you're brewing a yeast-driven style. Belgians, Hefs, Saisons, or even esters for English and Aussie Coopers style beers. If you're underpitching and need the yeast to multiply fast, but you must have strong temperature control to prevent off flavors. The best practice? That depends on what you are trying to achieve, but pitch within the yeast's recommended range for balanced results. Try and have the yeast as close to the same temperature as the wort as you can, and make sure you control the ferment temperature where needed. A few degrees can make a huge difference. So how do you pitch your yeast? Do you go cold and controlled, or warm and wild? Drop a comment below and let's talk brewing. And if you found this helpful, hit the like button, subscribe for more brewing tips, and I'll see you next time. Cheers. So how do you pitch your yeast? Do you go cold and controlled, or warm and wild?
If I looked a little frustrated during this video, it was because it was the third time I'd recorded it in a row. My camera autofocus is playing up. Donations accepted. Take it easy.
Cheers. Big shout out goes to my patrons. please consider checking out my Patreon page if you haven't before. There's typically a video up every week of what's going on in the brewery. And without those guys, I couldn't continue doing this. Thank you very much. Cheers.